Hello everyone, welcome back to the Binding of Isaac something or other. We have a lot to do. We have greedy emo to do on basically every enemy. Yeah, that's what they are. Apollyon has nothing done. Let's do a hard mode Apollyon. We have actually beaten Delirium with Apollyon, so we need... We've also done Hush, we've done Boss Rush, and we've done Mom's Heart. So we need to do Isaac, we need to do the Lamb, and by extension, we have to do the things before them, Satan and Blue Baby, and the Lamb, and therefore Satan and Isaac. Let's just do that. We've got the Suck, as we all do. It plagues us all. Actually, Curse of the Labyrinth on the very first floor can be a bit of difficulty when the very first floor is the cellar, because it's much easier to get hit on the cellar than... That thing just spawned twice in very quick succession. Which makes me upset. At least the other one has taken itself out of the equation. Jiminy. It was the agent of its own destruction by having produced an enemy that exploded very close to it. But I'm still not happy with the sheer amount of enemies that plague me upon this screen right now. Okay, good. A bomb is fine. Spirit hearts, please. Well, we suck this. Absolutely. It rerolls into... I don't know. I saw it reroll, but I'm pretty sure we have the D6 in our arsenal. Right now. No, not a secret room. Okay. We will find the other item room. There is a red chest which could be valuable to us. I will consider it. Yep. As noted, the cellar is a great opportunity to take damage because there's fucking spiders all over it, which are usually essentially impossible to avoid. And we were not lucky enough to have found a spirit heart up to this point. Also no tinted rocks that could be a spirit heart. Do you know what? I'm going to try the red chest and it could be spirit heart. Try the red chest. It was flies, which is... some protection. It's not HP protection, which is what I want because we could die. I don't really want to die. Nor do I want to waste flies on a couple of spiders. At least trapped spiders that pose no threat. But we'll keep going. And try not to get hit by a champion because that will immediately kill us. Let's not have the first run back be an awful loss that we could have easily prevented. Due diligence and correct fire safety procedures. That was a fine instance of this room because this little shitbag did not try it. Oh, fucking holy fucking mantle. It is already a win. Holy mantle is almost never a loss. Unless you're bad. It is quite possible to take two hits on a room, but unless you're the loss, that's not usually a problem. So... this almost guarantees us for the next floor the deal with the devil, because it's essentially half a spirit heart for every room. Bombs a key is okay. Don't mind the key, actually, because we will have an item room on the next floor. We're going to want to open. We don't have enough money to open the shop. Well, we can open the shop, but we needn't. It will be not worth our while. Or our key. We have the money. Suck stuff on it, but... I don't think you can suck the shop unless you pay for it. You can use the crooked penny on the shop, but we haven't unlocked that and we don't have that. So why are you talking about it then? Well, just spitballing. I'm theory crafting. That was really bad. I got stuck on the thingy. Is this going to get either? It got the thing, but I don't want the thing. I want the thing. It is the secret room, so at least I was not completely out of line to have used another bomb here. And it's not a re-rollable thing, but it is bombs a key, which is useless right now. Let's do the bosses. In fact, we haven't actually done the bosses yet, so we still could get a deal with the devil. So we increase our deal with the devil chance to 46%, which is near as makes no odds. 50%, it does make some odds, because it's literally odds, but you understand my point. 50%. Which means we've got approximately a 50% chance. We've basically got a coin flip for the deal with the devil right now, which is fine with me. And this version of Little Horn is actually, in my opinion, slightly easier. Unless it literally puts those bombs right on top of you and therefore hits you, which I don't think it can do. Because you don't have to avoid that tier that's being piloted around the room. Also, we have Holy Mantle, so we had very little chance of that being a problem. We have a tiers upgrade with two Spirit Hearts, which I immediately lost because I forgot that those fires were not mine. But at least I had taken the Spirit Hearts first. And then we can always re-roll and suck at the same time. Which is an interesting concept now I think about it, because if you re-roll, maybe I shouldn't have taken the D6. I mean, it's not like we could have re-rolled the D6 and sucked the result. We would have had to re-roll Holy Mantle or the void itself, which I didn't want to do. So what are we doing this time? I think we're going to go to Blue Baby. We're going to do the chest. We've already done the hard stuff. We did not get our coin flip to pay out for us, but we do have a trinket. And honestly, I thought that was a Spirit Heart, but it's not apparently, so fuck me, I guess. We want to do Isaac. I asked that question because, of course, I said the Void, and that is the name of the item, but it's also where we're not going. I will take Mystery Sack, even though I wouldn't mind a few stat upgrades, please. Maybe I should have sucked up the Crackjacks box, but at the same time, I don't mind having the trinket that we do have. It's actually a pretty decent trinket. And to have the opportunity to get further trinkets could be more beneficial than a random stat upgrade at this stage of the game. Especially, I mean, if it was a guaranteed stat upgrade that we got from the Void item, then yeah, you could persuade me to swap if I knew what it was going to be. But I mean, at least you make a case, but if it's going to be random, it'd probably end up being ranged. I don't really care about range that much. Damage would be great though. Well, we did that room to no avail. We have done boss rush. I think that's what the star means on here. So, do you know what? This is a bad idea. I regret everything. Just take the hit. I was going to say, do you know what? We just walk across with Holy Mantle, but Holy Mantle, the pseudo-invincibility you get for using Holy Mantle did not last nearly long enough. That was a whip on a bomb, by the way. I should have used it here if I was going to completely fail. Did not last long enough to get us into the curse room, so didn't quite work to plan, but we got a dime out of that room, so I'm already starting to feel a little bit better. We can just do this. The Hierophant means we can do this, and just we walk out of the room and walk back into it, and it resets your Holy Mantle charge, so you can do that as many times as you want. So we haven't lost that card that we, pill that we had, even if we cared about losing a pill, which is Bombs are Key, I think, so it could be valuable at some point. Except we're getting plenty of keys anyway. Where did that come from? Mystery Sack must have paid out with a double key. Let me out. Phew. So we come out here, we go in here. Get our two keys. So now Bombs of Key are starting to look good, because if we're going to be getting a lot of keys from pennies anyway, thanks to our trinket, we could just swap all our six keys for six bombs, or you know, whenever we choose to, and not feel like we're going to be in a bad place for keys for the next few floors, because we can expect to get some more from picking up coins. We can expect to get some coins because we don't have anything really preventing us from doing so. So I think I will do that. I'll use Bombs of Key now. See, there's two more keys already, so it's totally worth it. Put a bomb here for the secret room, which is pills, which we will definitely try out. I'm excited, does not make me happy. Telepill. Hopefully we can tank the I'm excited penalty. Ooh, get across. Yeah, I'm excited penalty without too much of a problem. Like before we even meet any more enemies. Infested is fine. Telepills is good to know, but it wasn't useful here. Yeah, we'll take a syringe, especially one that's a speed upgrade. Range doesn't really matter to me that much, but speed does. So these rooms are fast. I'm excited. We'll continue to be fast for a while. But we can do things like that because we're amazing Isaac players. And get on with our lives, which is fine with me. Guppy item, please. Not a guppy item, but plenty of keys, so we're okay there. I will take spider mod. And I would like to also take the ladder, because the ladder, I think, is an underrated item, because Northern Line said it was, so it is. But yeah, it does help you to get many consumables that you wouldn't be able to get to in other cases. I'm not sure if it would be that useful on this particular floor right now, come to think of it. But I guess we could reroll things that we can't suck. For example, the shop or a deal with the devil, which we are currently guaranteed, and it's very unlikely that we can take any damage that would prevent us from getting it, unless we fight something like a very, very tanky version of the bloke that would just simply never give us the opportunity. So I'm excited if actually going up and down I'm excited if going up and down in effectiveness, whether it's actually active or not. Probably should have put this over here ages ago, so we didn't have to wait for it to explode, but that's okay. Right, so we can reroll the deal with the devil, because we will be unable to suck the items on the deal with the devil until we've paid for them. Or we can pay for them and then suck them if there is a spacebar item that we want. Or some combination of both would be pretty decent, I think. So you are now invincible, which makes me sad. So I'll put this here and hope you are not invincible when I do that. Correct. Put this here. Rag Mega is a bit of a dick. Bye. Died. Why can you not take damage ever? It won't take damage ever. It's like, hello. Oh no, you can still shoot me. I'm going to hide again. It just seems like a prolonged fight for no reason. That was a perfect opportunity to shoot the fucker, but couldn't. Stop turning around, though. That's my big qualm right now. I'm fucking turning around all the time. I'm trying to put a bomb in a sensible location. Oi. Enough of that. Right, some HP. I'm happy with it. And I want both of these. I don't want these enemies, though. When I said both of these, I meant the items. So I'm not going to suck either of them. I think they're both perfectly decent damage upgrades. Pentagram is 1.69 per 69. And that's another 1.26. So I'm okay with it. Let's just go. Boring. We're not going to be on time for boss rush, I think. And that's kind of okay. We are going to speed up. Because we just got a decent damage upgrade. But not to that great of an extent that I'm expecting boss rush will be likely, although we could potentially get to it, but unless it's got something in it that we want or we get a way out of it, I'm not that bothered. So we haven't really made a great use of our suck item, but I think if you're not using the void, that's usually okay, because it means that your run is being given good enough items that you don't need it. Look at this dodging. Wow. I've been learning from the best. Luck upgrade from a penny is also fine. So we can get into this room, and we will explode these. Bombs of key would once again be quite nice. Do I want the locust of death, I think? Or conquest? Is the locust of conquest exploding? Because if it is, I don't really want it. Or do I want more keys from pennies? This chub is far too fast. Because I only have one bomb, I don't really want to use it against the chub, but I mean, I guess it doesn't matter if we keep swapping this trinket around right now. Kill the thing that's spawning the thingies rather than just the thingies that are being spawned. That would make sense. And it's so fast that I can barely land any shots because it keeps changing direction before they arrive. We got HP back, which is also nice, because having not enough HP was how we got in here in the first place. These eyes are not just annoying things to avoid, but they're annoying things that get in the way of you actually shooting it. So you have to keep doing these wide-ass dodges like this. rocket in on the other side of them. Shoot it. I hope that it doesn't do that jump in such a way that the tear will hit you. Okay, that was fine. We'll check out the Locus of Conquest and see if the... And of course, we don't need keys now. For this floor, at least. We'll check out the Locus of Conquest and see if it's exploding. It's not exploding. In fact, that was 110 damage from one fly, so... Unless it was 130, which would be double our actual damage, which seems fine. It looks like it rounds damage up to the nearest 0.1. Oh, yeah, the nearest 0.1. I'm getting two flies, 130, that is correct. I think I'll keep the Locus of Conquest, because it's going to speed us up just that little bit extra, which I'm okay with. Dagars we don't need right now. But we'll save it, because it could really help us out in a future lore. Anything with a curse on it, basically. We don't need the Spirit Heart at this stage of the game. This is Verbeen. So I'm not even going to suck, because... unless we reroll it first and then get... Nah, we didn't. I was hoping that the suck would be a reroll, and then we'd suck up the rerolled result, and therefore it would be a random stats upgrade by virtue of it becoming a passive item. Whoa, didn't expect that to bounce the way it did, but okay. But that's not what happened. We now have the bean on a 6-room charge instead of a recharge charge. This is still zero value to me. We might as well recharge it. Deal with the devil would be great. We do only have a 36% chance, but that's the same chance as if we'd taken red heart damage. And we didn't. So, we almost can't. Rune is Yarrow. I mean, the Yarrow rune is good enough to keep for the whole game, so I'm going to. We will take it all the way down to the chest. Got hit there somehow. That doesn't normally happen. I thought I had this rune down, but I don't. Right, so here's an opportunity to reroll and not suck. So we should definitely consider whether we want to. Especially if there's a battery charge available. There's a reroll available. Let me take the compass. That did give us a small devil bonus as well. And now there are no more... Well, we can reroll... We can restock it. And then maybe reroll the resulting items. Let's see if it works. It does work. And then we take the PhD for half price. That was fine. I'm happy with that. We might not have a reroll ready for the boss. I mean, a suck ready for the boss, but... I think that's okay. I think I'm okay with that. We haven't got a bomb. And I can't get into the secret room if I don't have a bomb. Please. We now have a bomb. How quickly things change. Money. Money helps. I would like another bomb to get some money out of this coin person. Not that bothered by it. PhD now means that we know what all our pills are, and they should all be at least... not bad for us. I think I'm excited still happens in PhD, but at least you don't... You know about it, so you're not going to take it. 16 minutes on the caves too. Why am I taking so long? Hagalaz. We got our Yarrow rune, and we have our battery charge back as a result of having found a battery charge. The Conquest... Locus of Conquest is actually being really helpful. We haven't used any keys on this floor as a result of having had the gold keys. So. Oh... Forever taking boss. How much HP can you possibly have? Wow. So we have a small deal with the devil chance. It's a bit less than a dice, a coin flip right now, but so not that much less. And we did get it, which means we can reroll it or suck it. Of course. It would give me the one deal with the devil that I can't re-roll and then suck. This is hard. Let me out. I don't want to do this anymore. Change my mind. I take it back. Erase and rewind. I mean, there's no reason not to take it, right? Sucky sucky. It re-rolled into the Necronomicon, but we got the effect of the Krampus's head. So if we want to, we can use Krampus' head on a room and maybe get sort of in repayment, we can get a battery charge to put it back all back together again and still use it as a suck later. It's an offensive option for an item that is otherwise a utility, which is helpful. Got another Yera room, so we could Yera something on this floor if we so chose. Perhaps a chest of some description. Can the flies please stop running into the invincible part of these enemies? Because how do these things behave when they're feared? It's impossible. There we go. Because they run in, like, they choose a direction to run. But when they're feared, they run away from you. But they choose a direction and then continue in it. And then I don't know if the running away overrides the direction. There's an item room over here somewhere, so we probably want to go to that. This room is a bit of a shit show. I haven't got a charge, so I can't, I got hit twice. Apparently it's quite possible to get hit twice on a room when you have pretty poor DPS like this. It's not that we have poor DPS, it's that every single champion appears to have about 5 times as much HP as I'd like it to. I mean, thank you to Spider-Mods for slowing this enemy down just long enough for it to not be able to reach me. We're not going very fast, which means our DPS has not been good enough. It's not like I've been missing a huge number of shots, right? I mean, enemies like this do tend to put a little bit of a spanner in the works for me because I'm not very good at dealing with them. We finally are a little bit faster. That is a perfect suck opportunity right there. Right there! So we are going to get a battery charge out of this room. Thanks to the Cocus of Long Quest. We have Curse of the Maze, so we'll purge that because I hate it, and now we don't have Curse of the Maze. I mean, I like the curse in concept, but I also kind of hate it. Right, good. So, I don't need to wait for that because we have Holy Mantle, Harry Mandel. I will buy something from this shop. It will be Hive Mine because we have the Cocus of Long Quest, and we will explode this to see if we get anything that we want to save up for in the future. We have got Diplopia available to us. Interesting. We're not going to get to Bosphorus, so we can't use it there, but we could buy it and reroll and then Diplopia something else. But then we might as well buy that other thing. Diplopia can Diplopia multiple things, right? So I suppose that is the thing you would be thinking of, is if you buy Diplopia and then reroll into multiple items, you can have more for the price of the original Diplopia. Seems like a bit of a long shot. It was a Perthro. We're on the decks one, so we take the Perthro for Deal with the Devil or just boss item reroll opportunities, and then maybe we can suck the result or keep it because we like it. That is also enough money to go to the shop again. So if you like the boss item, you take it. We Perthro it if we don't like it because the boss pool is slightly better than the shop pool, at least for now, while we've still got. You know, we bought the compass, but there are some decent shop items still. I still think that the boss pool is slightly better. I really hate these ghosts, though. Especially when they hit you such that you can no longer shoot them. Alright. And if we like the boss item, we take it, and then we could always suck the second boss item if we wanted to. A feared portal still attacks. That's still creates enemies, that's bullshit. Yera again. Probably should have Yera'd that. You know what, we should Yera the Perthro room. Then we can reroll as many things as we like. We have way too many Yera rooms on this floor right now. We Yera the Perthro room and take one of them.
Yera.
We've already missed boss rush, that's how slow we are. But at least our flies are now really big thanks to Hive Mind. So we did get a good benefit out of this floor, which was itself Hive Mind. And an okay upgrade. I didn't even check what stats we got from Soy Milk. I just knew I wanted to reroll Soy Milk because it offends me. HP is fine. And it is the Fallen. So in fact, the Fallen takes the Devil Pool, not just the Boss Pool. So having a Perthro for this is a lot more valuable than using it on the shop. I hit from that, although we have this, so I want it. Okay, good. The Dagar's rune we might as well use now, because we're going to take with us a Yera rune, but since we're going so slowly anyway, we'll min-max a little bit more, go to the shop, per-throw it, see if we want to buy anything. Another Yera rune.
Yera.
Fine. Per-throw the shop. We could also explode the shop. Let's explode the shop until there are two items on it. Although I do like this. Seems like a good idea. If you can give me something I actually want, I'd be very grateful. Let's see what this is. Two of diamonds.
Two of diamonds.
A four of diamonds, because we literally just picked up the item that makes that. So happy to give you some spirit hearts until you start paying out. Because we have a good supply of those. Well, we don't have an actual consistent supply of those, but they seem to be showing up a lot.
Infested.
I don't want this trinket. Although, seriously, if you wanted to actually pay out, that would be sweet too. Ten of hills. Could get us out of boss rush, but can't get into boss rush. Dude, though. I mean, we can pick up the HP that we spent on this anyway. 72 keys. All these two ops are really good. Let's keep going with this new red heart that we found ourselves. And you have paid me with a two of hearts.
Two.
Perfect.
Of
Wait.
Hearts.
Oh yeah, that was right. Gimpy. Worth it. Definitely worth the time we spent. Where is the Yera rune? Down here? Yes. Okay, let's leave. Way behind time for all the things, but we've already done the things that are gated by time. We just need to make sure that we survive. And I think Gimpy will help with that. It's not like it's going to be a great benefit, but if we've actually got red HP, which we do, Gimpy is a lot more valuable. Or if we had Dark Bum, which we don't, but, you know, we fulfill the first criterion, so it doesn't really matter about the second one at this stage. That's okay too. So in our sucky item, we have the bean, which is of zero value. We have the D6, which is of some value, but only if the item is on a pedestal that would not be sucked up. And we have the head of Krampus, which is of quite a lot of value, because if we are going to keep getting a decent amount of battery charges, then we have many opportunities to use it. What's this though? Glaucoma, blind tears. Everything went slightly darker. I didn't notice a stat upgrade. I probably should just look at what it does, but I like the mystery of having picked something up, not really knowing what it does, and seeing if it actually noticeably benefits our run. Oh yeah. We did just see a confusion effect on an enemy, but there's a chance that that was just spider-fucking. Oi! That thing's got bloody better bloody homing tears than I could. This is our secret room here. Cursed room is tempting because it's free. I don't really want to be larger, but we will be infested. Can't get into the boss trap room without an arcade, and it's not an arcade floor, so. Well, it would be, but it hasn't got one. Yeah, I think glaucoma may be causing these confusion shocks. Stop that. But I don't. Maybe the first time you hit an enemy, it becomes very. Or maybe there's a chance that if you hit an enemy, it becomes permanently confused. Because that enemy did not lose its confusion effect nearly as fast as I had expected it to. It's going to walk back out and walk back in again. Get our holy mantle reset and go in here. We will get three guppy items from two chests. Did get a guppy's tail though, which is fine because we have 71 keys, which is likely to be quite beneficial for us. Right, let's go to the boss. Finally get through this run, which has been very slow because we've been trying our best to do it right. There's our Yera rune, which we do want to keep because we're going to the chest. And it's always fun to have eight chests rather than four with guaranteed items in them. We These flies are doing a great amount of damage, by the way. Oh, it won't be. Boing. It will be 16 chests. Because our Yarrow rune will be doubled in effectiveness because we picked up the Tarot Cloth, which I think is actually a really, really good item, even though its effect is very simple. And that kind of risks getting into the whole, you know, where's the imagination in Afterbirth Plus? But I think not everything has to be a massively, hugely imaginative, you know, coup. Like, not every item has to be the cleverest item ever. Some of them are allowed to just be, eh, that's okay. Decent idea. Works quite well. You know, well-balanced, sensible idea, plays with something that we don't normally get to play with. You know, it's almost like blank card once. On every card. But every card is blank carded and then used. I saw the foot. I heard the noise. And I went back into the shadow. Our damage is pretty abysmal. I mean, 7 damage at this stage of the game is very, very average. But I guess if you think about it, the average run is only just good enough. You know, it's not every run can get to boss rush, and I wonder if the average run, especially if you are, you know, I wouldn't say timid, but you know, a cautious player who wants to make sure that they win. Why are you over there? If you're a cautious player, then the average run probably doesn't get to boss rush because you're taking more time than that would allow, which is fair. You know, you can't get to boss rush all the time, which means you have to have an above average run to get to boss rush. This really, really is not. We did get a deal with the devil. I would like Rotten Baby because we have Hive Mind. What I'm going to do is I'm going to reroll this into Guppy's fucking 9 lives, which is great. So now we are 1 Guppy item away from Guppy itself. Probably should have gone to the shop, but eh. Minor mistake, I think. It could be a... excuse me, it could have been a good shop. But we will never know. So Rotten Baby is going to be producing flies faster than the... No, not this curse again. Faster than the trinket is, because Rotten Baby will be continually producing flies, whereas the trinket will only produce one in every room. That's okay. We have an Elder's Rune, which I think will be beneficial at some point, no doubt. Not a fan of these mushrooms that are disappearing all the time. Alright, so we have Guppies 1 and Guppies 2, so we need Guppies 3, and then we will be guppied to all heck. So a deal with the devil or a curse room? There is a curse room on this floor, but it's a long way away. I think it's worth it because we have Holy Mantle. If we didn't have Holy Mantle, I probably wouldn't condone going quite so far for such a thing. But this room works out really well considering I'm usually bad at everything. Bob's Rotten Head is a thing, that's for sure. I'm not even going to suck it because it's just going to be an annoying thing to remember not to hurt yourself with when you actually come to suck. Hagalaz Rune could accidentally find us a Tinted Rock, but I don't really hold out much hope for that being the case. So let's go to our boss fight. It is the Bloat, which is not my favourite thing in the world. I guess we try and... I think the trick to the boat is Bloat is to try and bait it into doing attacks that you can then attack otherwise. Except in this case, the trick to beating the Bloat is to just get Rotten Baby to throw flies in there all the time. So we've got the Halo, which is worth taking. I don't want to be in this room, so why did you go to it? Smart ass. Don't ask questions. I know better than you. We have the Elder's Rune still. Could get us through a room we don't like. Which is all of them. But then our flies are just doing so much damage, I'm hardly thinking that the Elder's Rune is actually going to be any good to us at all. We have a battery charge somehow. That also helps us get through a room we don't like. And if we get Guppy's head from somewhere, presumably the curse room. I mean, we could suck it for the occasional fly. It hardly seems worth it. But I guess you, like, why wouldn't you? There's a hell of a lot of things right there. Four Elders rooms. I'm taking all this money because of A, luck upgrades, which are going to be really, really good on the chest. There's a whole bunch. And also, if we get money equals power or the Midas Touch, I'm going to be a fan of that too. Having all this extra money in the first place. This champion of champions, king of kings, is not my king. Play this if you get blood back. Didn't happen. But we can get half a heart from one of these. Many enemies are dropping half hearts, so we try and get one, which will give us a half heart interval at some point in the future. So there's a trick to this room that I've never considered. Go halfway into it to dodge the first row, such that the second row attack you. Then go back around the first row. There's Gimpy. And shoot them in the arse. Ooh, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, it worked though. Worth it. There's a... We're already at full speed, so that doesn't really help. Guppy, please. Thank you for the flies for not being affected by that thing's bullshit. Dagars. Dodging. Dagars, and I have a random... That wasn't Dagars, that was Algis. Why did it say Dagars and give me Algis? Whatever. Guppy? I mean, the alternative to that being good. The alternative way that could be good is simply to give me a... Fuck it. I don't want to do this room.
Telepill.
It's a good thing we have Holy Mantle. Is that it gave me a deal with the devil, which would also be really fine. Let us exit this pesky floor. There's not a lot that we have for ourselves. Like, there's not a lot that we can do for ourselves right now, is the thing. We just have to wait for the game to give us what we need. No, there's not a secret room. This could be, though. I'm actually going to check the super secret room, which could be here. Plenty of bombs. It is, so I don't have to go any further. This is fine, too. And another HP upgrade also is fine with me. Come on. There we go. What's this message? I will read it later. This is not the time. There is another... There's a boss trap room, which we can't get to. There is no curse room, but there is a dice... There's a chest room, which I'm going to go and check out. Presuming it's this way, which it is. Alright, cool. These flies are more than enough right now. 99 cents. Stop collecting cents. You are not making any more sense. This room is a bit of a shit show. It's a good thing we have Fear Shot right now, actually, because it's really helping these things... understand that they need to be running away from me. It's helping me not walk into them because they are constantly running away from me. Open up. Bomb bag. Well, it's just what we needed. Even more bombs. There's a self-sacrifice room that I'm not going to play. This is not the way to it. But it's probably easier to beat this room than to try and get our way out of it. So I am going to. Secret room? Another Yara rune? Another Yara rune. So we could use that. Not really too inclined to go all the way back for another Yara rune. Answers rune basically solves all my problems. Can get into the boss trap room, so I'm going to. Could be red chests. Could be Guffy. Don't need those. Could be Guffy. This is not Guffy. Could have doubled it, but I think a doubled chest like that will give you the same payout twice. Rather than being random each. Unless that's changed in Afterbirth Plus. But I suspect it has not. I don't know. Probably should have tried it. Yeah, I get it. You don't want to be picked up. I'm not going to explode you for 5 cents that I don't need. And then Loki is always the last one. Always, like, always one of them. And it's kind of right. Well, I got hit. But Holy Mantle was there. my underwear to take me to the fair. Daddy wasn't there. We got a small devil update grade chance, which is why I exploded that guy in the first place. Can you not do that moonwalk bullshit towards me, please? I mean, these things don't seem to shoot you when they're feared, so I'm happy for them to remain feared forevermore. It's such a slow run. Despite the fact that we're doing so... suddenly doing so well on DPS, I feel. Especially with these flies, with Hive Mind. Even an infested rune would be great right now. Pill. Don't need the bombs or the keys, but I'm taking them anyway. We might as well do what the map says rather than what our gut says, because our gut is wrong, because our gut is not really cartographically relevant. Nothing in there that interests me. Pills may be good. Drowsy, something's wrong. Check this room. That was a bad bomb, but it should do it, yeah. Yeah, sure. Why don't we pay this chap? The IV bag does not interest me. Why am I picking up the coins that I don't need yet? But he could give us some money. Some HP is what I meant, but he gave us mom's coin purse, which is fine. We do have PhD. Maybe we could have yarrowed it. Up. I really care to.
Infested?
Two luck upgrades and infested pills. Okie doke. I don't really fancy. Screw it. We did do some damage. It wasn't my favourite. Because there's a battery charge. Although, now I think about it, we can't go and get the battery charge without risking losing any deal with the devil that we do get. We could suck any items on the chest that we don't like as well. There are going to be 16 items. So, if they're passive items we don't care about, into the suck they go. We will avoid them. Avoid them. Envoid them? That was a bad dodge. I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it. I will get the battery charge out of principle. There's two of them. Well, you know what they say. Two battery charges are better than one. Cathedral. Nearly there. It's dark in here. Do not appreciate that. Boss looks like... I pressed Q by accident because I got fat fingers. Okie dokie. We don't have our Yara rune anymore. We may get another one. We've had several that we didn't want, so... hopefully we can get one that we do want. Because I don't have it anymore and I want it. Look. Stop being difficult to kill when you're feared, okay? Thank you. Is that too hard? There now. Was that so much to end? Yes, AWAS.
AWAS.
Not even a black market. What are you playing at? Happy birthday to the famine. Red chest, not guppy. Very well. What is this? I do not know, but it is not going to give me flies, and I'm relying on flies. More portal. Please be guppy in the mob trap room, which will be a boss trap room. Bomb. Guppy? Guppy's head. Not good. Spirit heart's fine. Also not good his head. He is meaningless. Very well. More spirit hearts. Even this monster is not taking that much damage. It's not a tanky version, is it? It might be. If it was a champion, a hollow. No, Larry Jr. So it was possibly a champion monster. That's right, it took a bit longer, but still. And a champion chub. Fast but weak, maybe? Really? That's how we're playing this game. You're gonna dodge my bomb and then bite me? I think not, Sunshine. Can you get a guppy anything from a brown chest? Maybe not. Do I want this spirit heart? Eternal heart? Yes! 1,000 times yes. By the gods. That was very hard room. Do not want. Okay, good. Please give me a Yara rune back. I feel foolish. We could still get one on the chest. so we don't have to actually open the items on the chest. But algae's. And we could do a few more rooms to try and get one more. I think it's going to be... You get one every four rooms, so... This will be one room, then the blue baby fight will be two rooms. So, it's not like there's far to go. I can't believe we got Krampus's head instead of Lump of Coal. Lump of Coal would be great right now, because we've got pretty good range. That's Bob's rotten head. That's Bob's brain, in fact. Not even Bob's rotten head. Couldn't help but notice that Bob's brain is bigger than Bob's rotten head. Although it is wrong, so I guess maybe it's shrunk in the wash. Maybe it's Bob's shrunken head. Maybe he got cannibals. I mean, a shrink is called a shrink because they shrink your head, metaphorically, but I don't think they literally shrink your head, so... Because, you know, the concept of having a big head. I assume that's what it is. If you have a big head, then you'll bully yourself, so if you shrink your head, then you stop being bullying yourself. So presumably a psychiatrist is entirely there. Stop people having a big ego. You can stop taking damage on the blue baby fight. That will probably help. You take damage against your own... Yeah, I think it took damage against its own holy light array. It does. That's pretty nice. I really like it. You may continue to do that. So we have a small chance of getting the Yarrow Rune back. Possibly the correct thing to do would be to simply not fuck it up in the first place, but that wasn't an option. Maybe you remap the keys so you don't press Q when putting your hand back on the keyboard. Or, you know, drop the error rune until you're ready to use it. I picked up Bob's brain because the not accidentally picking up an item mechanic chose not to work for me today. Well, we've got a luck upgrade, which I think I'm going to take. Because more chests on the chest are going to be good for us. We already have... That was lucky. We already have... Well, we got a small rock. That's nice. We already have flies from Rotten Baby. The noise this thing is making is very disconcerting. That is an Answers rune. One makes you larger. I don't think we need any of those. So we might as well take Answers so we can see where we're going. Three black hearts is not disagreeable. Let's just go take the answers rune so we can see on the chest. We didn't get what we wanted. That's okay. We'll go in. It's a shame because, of course, 16 chests is funny. The Locust of Wrath has appeared in the basement, so we only had to get this far as Apollyon to unlock that. We'll use answers without curse of the lost knife. We do get the soul, which is friendly. Dead Eye is really good. Lead Pencil is okay. Probably should have sucked it. I'm going to suck this, which gave me a luck upgrade and a speed upgrade I can't have. This is no help for anybody. So, thanks for that. Okay, so it looks like the pencil is occasionally causing me to do... Wow, okay. Monstrous lung shots without having to charge them up. Or maybe it doesn't at the time that they would happen had to charge them up. Maybe if I paid attention to the map. Yeah, we want to go. Careful about Bob's brain, of course. We also got biohazard. No, contagion. Contagion is the basically palette swapped version of toxic shock, and its effect is simply that an enemy will spawn poison when it dies. And then any other enemy caught in that poison will be quite negatively affected. Then it just continues to spread. Anything that's been poisoned will continue to take damage and spread the poison. I think it's an anti-birth item, but I'm not sure if that was independent. We've got God's Flesh and Explosivo, which are okay. Probably could have done with maybe sucking them. I'm thinking I should be sucking more than I am, because we're taking a lot of tier effects that don't really give us a great benefit. We did take Fruitcake, so we're already getting a lot of these tier effects. So maybe we should start sucking passive items to try and get a damage upgrade or a rate of fire upgrade. Our rate of fire is okay, and our damage is passable. yeah, that was a damage upgrade, so that was worth doing. I will use a bomb to stop having to backtrack and take this battery charge, which is why I went in there in the first place. So a small damage upgrade, but that's okay. I was flashing as though I took damage, but Holy Mantle protected me, but I still got the Holy Mantle graphics, so I'm not sure what happened there. And what are these bright Deadeye... crazy. Got these Deadeye Explosivo shots. Those are both spacebar actions, so I don't really want them. Just unfortunate. And I get a free super secret room, which is why I came here in the first place. Not for a free one, just for one. Which contains more HP, which isn't hugely useful. Per throw. That's probably more useful, if you come down here and use it. Sure. That's another damage upgrade, so I'm happy with that. And a tears upgrade! That's exactly what I wanted my sucker to be doing for me. Did a little bit get trapped there, but that's okay. Firemind is dangerous, but okay. The Parasite is very nice, especially with the range that we have. Of course, with these loot shots we're occasionally getting from Fruitcake over there, there's a good chance that our Firemind shots just explode in a very strange place indeed. Soul is going to protect me from a lot of these Blue Baby shots that I'm incapable of dodging myself. Except that one. But we're done. We've done it. Well done, me. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that episode. That is an unlock for us. It's going to say the Locust of Famine, which I thought it already said, unless we already got the Locust of Wrath. So there you go. That's the two Locust unlocks just from doing an Apollyon run, which did take forever, but I apologise for that. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I'm hope that you will join me for the next one, even though they are coming on to an hour each. please stick around. See ya.